Hi, welcome to Barney Tech Channel. Here we are going to see about loss of field in generator production. Before going deep into the loss of field, I like to show some basic things about synchronous generator. First, we will see the SLD of power plant. Here the generator is connected with the grid. To have a simple view, the SLD I have modified like this. According to this topic, we have to consider three things which is connected with generator. First one is grid, second one is exciter, third one is turbine. The generator can give power supply to grid in normal running condition if exciter and turbine has good coordination with generator. In case, if any abnormal condition occurs on generator, it may receive power or war from grid. To have a clear understand on this, we have to go power graph first. In this, we have a four quadrants. Now we will see on first quadrant. Let us consider the generator is in good running condition and the turbine working fine. So the generator is able to produce power. Due to this, the power will be in positive. That is, P is in positive. And if exciter is also good working condition, then the rotor produce high magnetic field. Due to this effect, it will deliver war to grid. So Q is also in positive. Since P and Q in positive, the operation comes under first quadrant. Now we go for second case. In this case, the generator working good and turbine is also good. So the generator is able to deliver power to grid. So P will be in positive. Let us consider the exciter is not working. The working of rotor is to produce strong magnetic field. Since the exciter is not delivered power to rotor, so it has to take power from grid. Due to this, the war will be in minus. That is, it absorbs war from the grid. So P is in positive and Q is in minus. This case comes under fourth quadrant. Now we go for case 3. In this case, generator is in good running condition and exciter is also in good working condition. So it deliver war to grid. So Q is in positive. In this case, let us consider turbine is not working. If this connected to grid, then the generator get rotating power from the grid. Since it take power from the grid, P will be in minus. This positive Q and negative P combinations comes under second quadrant. Now we will see case 4. In this case, the generator is in good running condition and turbine is not running or it has some problem. So it takes power from grid. Due to this, power will be in minus. And also we are going to consider exciter is also not working. So it takes war from the grid. Due to this, Q is also in minus. So both P and Q are in minus. This combination comes under third quadrant. Now we will see all together. If generator has good turbine and exciter, then this case said to be synchronous generator. If generator has a good turbine and exciter not working, then this case said to be induction generator. In case if generator has a good exciter and turbine is not working, then this said to be a synchronous motor. This combination. In generator, if both exciter and turbine is not working, then this case said to be induction motor. From this, we all can able to understand that the synchronous generator can able to run or modify himself into any quadrant, that is any mode of operation. But this synchronous generator is designed for only for synchronous generator. That is, it has to be operate in first quadrant. If it is operate in other quadrant due to failures of turbine control or exciter problem, then it is danger for system and generator. In this topic is related with exciter. So we have to see which quadrant is linked with exciter problem. We'll see one by one. First quadrant is okay. All are running fine. When we go for second quadrant, it has problem, but the problem is on turbine, but exciter is in good running condition. So we no need to consider this quadrant. When you see the third and fourth quadrant, we can clearly see that we have an exciter problem over here. So we have to check only in this region. So when the generator comes under this region, so the loss of production has to be operate. So our relay setting should be over in this region. From this, you all may have a clear idea why we are checking on this region for loss of field. This production is based on impedance, so we consider R and X. I believe that you all may get a basic idea about this loss of field production. On next section, I will show the reason and its operating region for loss of field. We came to the end of the section. See you on next video. If you like this section, then please share to your friends and colleagues. Take care and bye from Barney Tech channel. Thank you for watching this video.